गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स. सो टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज द मसल्स ऑफ द बैक ऑफ द फोरआर्म. नाउ फॉर दिस विंडो वी हैव टू पुट इंसिशंस. फर्स्ट इंसिशन इज गिवन जॉइनिंग लैटरल वन हॉरिजॉन्टल इंसिशन जॉइनिंग लैटरल एंड द मीडियल एपिकोंडाइल. सेकेंड इंसिशन गिवन वन हॉरिजॉन्टल इंसिशन जॉइनिंग द रेडियल स्टाइलॉइड प्रोसेस एंड द अल्नर स्टाइलॉइड प्रोसेस. Then a vertical incision is given joining the midpoint of the two incisions, right? Next, skin flaps are reflected laterally and medially. So, in the forearm, first we have come across the superficial fascia. In the superficial fascia, we will get the radial nerve, superficial branch of the radial nerve, cephalic vein. So this is cephalic vein and this is radial nerve. On the medial side we will get the basilic vein as well as medial cutaneous nerve of forearm. Next, superficial fascia is reflected along the line of skin incision. Deep fascia is also reflected along the line of skin incision. Now in the deep fascia we will get one modification of the deep fascia that is called extensor retinaculum. So this structure, this is the modification of the deep fascia, this is the extensor retinaculum beneath which the extensor tendons are passing. Now the muscles of the forearm, back of the forearm, can be divided into two groups. One is superficial group and one is deep group. In the superficial group we have seven muscles. So first one is the anconius. This muscle is the anconius. So it arises from the lateral epicondyle and going to be inserted into the upper part of the posterior surface of the ulna. It is a triangular shaped muscle. So this triangular shaped muscle is the anconius. Next, the lateral most muscle of the superficial group is brachioradialis. So this muscle is the brachioradialis. So lateral most muscle in the superficial group is the brachioradialis. So this muscle is the brachioradialis. Next, beneath brachioradialis there is extensor carpi radialis longus and the brevis muscle. So together extensor carpi radialis longus and brevis muscle, and we can see here the tendons of the extensor carpi radialis longus and the brevis muscle. Tendons of the extensor carpi radialis longus and the brevis muscle. We can see here the tendons. So next muscle is the extensor digitorum. This is the extensor digitorum tendon. This is the extensor digitorum tendon. So we can see here there is the four tendons of the extensor digitorum, of which the medial most one is the tendon of the extensor digiti minimi. Now last muscle in the superficial group, that is the extensor carpi ulnaris. Okay, so let's recapitulate the superficial group. There are seven muscles. First one is the anconius. So this triangular shaped muscle is the anconius, arising from the lateral epicondyle, inserted into the upper part of the posterior surface of the ulna. Next, the lateral most superficial muscle, that is the brachioradialis. So this muscle is the brachioradialis. This muscle is the brachioradialis. Next is the extensor carpi radialis longus. So here is the extensor carpi radialis longus. Next is the extensor carpi radialis brevis. This one is the extensor carpi radialis brevis. Next, extensor digitorum. And the last one is the extensor digiti minimi. Next is the extensor carpi ulnaris. So these are the superficial groups of muscle. Next is the deep group. In the deep group, we have five muscles altogether. So first is the supinator, which is deep seated and which can be seen from the flexure aspect as it is forming the floor of the cuboidal fossa. So next, deep group muscle. Here is the tendon of the abductor pollicis longus and extensor pollicis brevis. So students, you can see here is the two tendon of the abductor pollicis longus and extensor pollicis brevis, which are winding round the lower part of the radius and crossing the extensor carpi radialis longus and brevis tendon. So these two are the extensor carpi radialis longus and brevis tendon, and these two tendon, they are crossing the extensor carpi radialis longus and brevis tendon. And here Here anatomical snap box is formed. So anatomical snap box, what is the boundary? Lateral boundary is by this abductor pollicis longus, extensor pollicis brevis. Medial boundary is by extensor pollicis longus. Floor, in the floor we have this extensor carpi radialis longus and brevis. And the content, in the content we have the radial nerve, in the superficial layer radial nerve and the cephalic vein. And in the deeper plane we have radial artery. Okay, so deep muscles. Next deep muscle is the extensor pollicis longus. Next one is the extensor indicis. So this one is the extensor indicis. So five muscles of the deep group. One is supinator. Next is abductor pollicis longus, extensor pollicis brevis. Next is extensor pollicis longus, and this one is the extensor indicis. So altogether 12 muscles in the back of the forearm. Thank you very much.